How do you feel about your office? Is it just a space for employees to work, or is it a space where your employees do their best work? When you're in the right space, it can bring your teams closer together and be where the best talent wants to work. When you're in the right space, it can make your life easier. Whether it's a new HQ or a satellite office, with WeWork, you can find a space that works for you. Visit we.co/spacematters to learn more.
Blog Talk Radio.
You are listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio, and this is Quatita Dean, your host. This is Soul Sessions Live. This is a show you must hear and see to believe. I have helped so many people connect with their loved ones to get the closure they deeply desired. This is my passion, and I can't wait to take you on a walk with the ancestors. Tune in each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m., Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Thank you.
welcome, welcome. Thank you for joining us with Soul Sessions Live. This is Soul Sessions Live, and you're listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. I am your host, Quatita Dean, and we have a great, great show lined up for you tonight. We have Hot Tea in the building. Say hello, Miss Hot Tea. And we have Hot Tea from Caked and Baked Makeup, Makeup Cosmetics and Artistry in the building. And we have Jazz the Medium that's going to be doing some reading for us tonight. But we're going to jump this thing off with the hot topics. And the hot topics, we're going to be speaking about Mr. Pedophile, Monster, Predator, R. Kelly. And we're going to bring Missy Tidmore into the building. So we're going to go ahead and bring her in and let her speak. I hope y'all hold on to your wigs, clutch your pearls, baby, because this shit ain't go down. This Soul Sessions Live, y'all.
How you doing?
I'm all right.
You are listening to Soul Sessions Live. Get ready for these hot topics. Let's get it.
All right, we're going to jump on into this thing. We are live streaming off Facebook. Make sure you're checking us out each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We live stream from Instagram on Wednesdays, and that is Queens_Domain1, and we live stream from Facebook on Sundays, and we have some Facebook viewers on. We have Michaela Labrador. She said this is her first time, so thank you and welcome. And so we're going to go ahead and get this thing started. We got Missy on the line. Missy, are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
How are you, Missy?
I'm doing good.
I am so grateful and thankful for you. You are so brave. Let me first off start by saying that shit. Because we're going to go ahead and talk about it all, because you inboxed me and said you wanted to talk about the R. Kelly because you wanted to stop living in the lie of your family, right?
Right. Just watching that movie just triggered something in me, and it pissed me off.
I know. I finished the last part today, and usually I prepare questions, but I feel like, you know what, I need to just let you go. You know what I'm saying? And let you do your thing. But let's go ahead and talk about it, because people don't understand what surviving R. Kelly was. Like, this is human trafficking. You know what I'm saying? This is a sex trafficking ring that he is all in by himself, and he has other predators that are helping him. So tell me, Missy, how you understand this story compared to what you saw, because you didn't necessarily go through it. You watched your family and sisters go through it.
Right. Just the whole part of when they did the interview with R. Kelly and he told, you know, what happened to him, it's like, I feel like a lot of black families hide that and keep that as a secret. Now, I've never personally been molested, but my older sister was molested by one of my uncles when she was only 4 years old. And my grandmother covered it up. And she's not the only one he did it to. It's others. And it's like a lot of stuff you don't realize when you're younger, but now that I'm older and since both of my parents have passed and me and my sisters have sat down and have talks about things, it's like everything just started to make sense. Even as a child, hearing stuff, you know, here and there, and I found out about my sister when I was actually in the 9th grade. I was in boarding school, and I got kicked out of boarding school, and I had to go stay with my dad for a couple of weeks. And we got into a big argument, and he just put it out there. So it's we got into an argument about one of his sisters saying something about my mom, and I called my mom and let my mom know. And he got mad about that and was like, well, your mom ain't shit anyway, because she let your uncle molest your sister. So I had never heard anything about that before. So I'm like, okay, you know what? I'm just going to go to the person. I'm going to ask my mom and I'm going to ask my sister. And I asked my sister about it, and she told me. And then my mom, she just was kind of like, well, you know, that's what my sister said, but I guess they never really talked about it or dealt with it.
Mm-hmm.
And I know, like, it kind of got pushed up under the rug. But I do know before my mom passed that she had a conversation with my sister, and she wanted my sister to forgive my grandmother for covering everything up. She wasn't worried about my sister, like, forgiving her. She was more worried about my grandmother. And
you
I don't understand that, but she...
That's crazy. I was just watching an interview with Carrie Kelly, which is R. Kelly's younger brother, and he was actually being very, not explicit, but very graphic as to what exactly happened about how their sister forced him to give her oral sex, and she returned it. He was all of 6 years old, and how she climbed on top of him and forced him into sex, and that he took it as a violation that he was no longer a virgin. Like, it affects people differently, and he said he never got up the nerve to tell his mother even before she passed. So did your sister, was she able to have that conversation with your mom? Like you said, she wanted her to forgive her, but did they actually go into detail? Like you said, at 4 years old, but was that only one time? Did this happen several times?
It happened more than one time. And I know my mom actually had a conversation with my uncle. I guess they did like a three-way call from jail. And still to this day, he's denying it.
You know what?
He's not admitting it.
I actually confronted one of my molesters, okay? And the first time I approached the situation, he apologized, and I thought we could move past it. But when he did it again, and I said something to him, he completely denied it. He said he had no knowledge of what I was talking about, although we had had that conversation. I feel like these people are monsters. They're predators. But, Missy, you said this is on both sides of your family.
Yeah, and also on my father's side of the family, his mother's side, she married another guy, not my father's father, but another man. She had kids with this man, and he molested grandkids. One of the daughters sent one of the daughters out. So by him doing that, and I mean molested boys and girls.
Wow.
It's like a domino effect, generational. Now, those grandkids molesting other kids, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, where does it stop?
Yeah. My God, that is insane. Like, listen, that's heartbreaking. You know what I'm saying? Because victims are victimizing. And it's like, where do we stop this at? Where does the healing begin at? Now, I know you said that when y'all went to spend a night with your grandmother, your older sister wouldn't go after the molestation had been brought to the forefront or had been exposed or stopped, right?
Right. Like, in the summertime, we would spend our summers with my grandparents. And then my sister, I guess she would go with my dad. And my grandmother she had a 3-bedroom house. The only time we would sleep in the spare bedrooms was when, like, all the grandkids were there or, like, it was, like, the house was like a family reunion. But if it was just us, because for some reason my grandmother always had us, my mom's kids, out of all of her grandkids. But she would make a pallet next to her side of the bed, and we always slept on the pallet by her side of the bed. And I never really understood why. I mean, it never bothered me. But now that I'm older, I understand to protect us from what happened, like, you know, with my sister. But still, she's still in denial about it. And I know that my dad would come and visit like, stop by and see me and my sister, and we would, like, go out to his truck and talk to him, and my grandmother would always stand in the doorway, like she was trying to listen to see what was said or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Just crazy. So he would never stay long. At the longest, like, 10 minutes.
You said to me the other day, you said that it wasn't just your sister. Please explain to everybody when you say it was your uncle, but he didn't just molest your sister, because I want people to understand why you felt like this was important to speak about.
Well, it was a couple of other cousins and also some kids that my mother babysitted.
Like the neighborhood
kids. And then I also wonder, because he did have a girlfriend that he had a child with, but that child passed. But that girlfriend had two smaller kids, a little boy and a little girl. And I always wondered, did he ever do something to the little girl?
That is crazy. And you said that your grandmother just felt like he couldn't do any wrong. It was something that she never wanted to really acknowledge.
No, and a matter of fact, when I've had gotten readings from you in the past, I always wanted her and my other grandmother to come through, because I had questions, like, you need to explain yourself, like, something,
yeah.
But they never came through the reading.
Yeah. I know, like, only reason why I even realized what had happened to your sibling is because one of your ancestors had brought it to the forefront. So this is not our first or second time speaking about it, but you did call, reach out to me, and I wanted to really let people know what monster this is. And when I say monster, I'm not speaking about one individual. I mean pedophilia, incest, molestation is a monster all in itself. You know what I mean? And people don't understand the effects, the lingering effects, because I don't know if you watched it. I think you said you watched the R. Kelly, right? Like,
I watched all of it.
The lingering effects of it, the way that people cover it up, they bring children to you. Like, it's amazing the level that people go to ensure that people are still victims. You understand what I'm saying? So it's, you know,
right.
And no disrespect at all to your family whatsoever, but you have been speaking out on it, and you have been losing family members.
I just feel like, if that's something that you condone, I don't even want to breathe the same air that you breathe. Because my sister is still dealing with that, lasting effects of that, and she just said she will never get over that. Like, she's mentally and emotionally damaged. It's like she keeps getting in these bad relationships. Her self-esteem is low. It's just, it's bad.
That is so, I'm so baffled by it. My daughter is a survivor of it. I am a survivor of it. And it makes you feel a certain way, so I can't quite understand how the parents off of that man's documentary was allowing this shit to continue to go on. Now, Missy, you said that you had said a few things. Let's be clear about a lot of things. I really want to go ahead and let you talk about it, because you said one of your cousins is pregnant by off of this.
Yeah, one of my younger cousins on my father's side, one of his mother's, one of his mother's kids, grandkids, molested by her uncle.
Wow.
And
she's
pregnant. Only 13.
You know, I don't care, you know, how old, like, to me, you can be brainwashed, and I my cutoff is 19. You understand what I'm saying? So it's like, after 19, you should know a little better, but you might not. But anything under the teen, as long as you have a teen in your age, I feel like this is completely off limits. It's unbalanced to some degree, you know. So what are they saying, though? Are people just not acknowledging it, Missy?
Honestly, that side of the family, since my father passed, I don't even deal with them. After we had, like, the big blow-up on Facebook about the man doing all of that, that was it. And it's been 4 years since my parents passed. Just because my cousin was trying to glorify this man to be something that he wasn't, I just let her know, like, this man ain't what you're trying to portray him to be. He a molester. And if I think about it, he probably molested her because she went to go stay with my grandmother because her parents didn't want her. But she got mad and was saying, well, we never, she got mad like we never came around because my dad didn't want us around that. That's why we never came around. It was only certain people my father wanted us around.
Mother, right? Not that she was, not that your father's mother was a molester, but he watched y'all because of the you said evil nature that she came with or whatnot.
Like, my dad took me around my grandmother a few times. I was never around her by myself. I was always with him a couple of times, and every time I went around her, I just wanted to leave. It was just like her energy was off. Her eyes were soulless. Like looking at the devil.
It should be swept under the rug so many times. And I just hate that, you know, people, we're still going through this. But it seems like it's getting, like this monster is gaining weight. You know what I'm saying? It really is. And the fact that it's on both sides of your family doesn't surprise me because it's on both sides of mine. You know what I mean? It's just about, it's starting to be exposed a little more. But to see, to hear your story and to also see what was happening to these young women being forced to eat and consume feces and drink piss and can't eat unless and move and go to the bathroom and pissing in corners and buckets, like, and then you understand that the police and judges are allowing this to happen. No wonder our girls and boys, because be clear, it's happening to boys as well. They're not speaking out because they feel like they have no voice. And if they do have a voice, they feel like it could be silent, you know.
And a lot of people blaming them. That's why they don't speak out.
We blame them, and it's ridiculous. So, it was it just your older sister? Like you said, you weren't. Was your other sister molested, or do you know?
That was said also. I'm not for sure, so I can't speak on her. She didn't give me permission to tell her story, but my older sister did give me permission to tell her story.
So, okay. Well, I definitely respect that. So what is, like, what did your sister say to you about your uncle? And, like, did she say what happened or, you know what I mean? Like, because people try to make a separation between, oh, that was fondling. That was, you know what I'm saying? Like, to me, it's
she
all
never
the same
got
anymore.
Into, she never got into, like, graphics of it. She just would say, like, him calling her back into the room and something about my grandfather being there when it happened, but she was saying my grandfather didn't know because he threatened her not to tell. So it's just, like, we talk, and she tells a little bit at a time as she goes.
It's probably too
much. But she also feels like why everything bad happened to her. That's how she feels.
I just hate that. Now, I know you hate it, you know, because it's like she took the brunt of it. You know what I mean? Because a lot of times.
Right. And I think she really wants people to acknowledge it.
Yeah, understood. And she may be able to heal if people start to acknowledge it. Is that uncle for you? Is he still living?
Yeah, he's in jail. Actually, he's been reaching out to me on Facebook, since my parents died, but I haven't responded back. And it's like I'm not really understanding what he wants from me. I haven't had a relationship with him. I don't want to have a relationship with him. And the last time I saw him was in 2011 at my grandmother's funeral. He came, they actually let him come from prison to the funeral, and I stayed clear away from him. Everybody else took pictures and stuff with him. I didn't go anywhere near him. I just stood off just looking at him, just disgusted. I didn't want to, because that wasn't a time and place for me to act up, but yeah, I had a lot of stuff going through my head.
Understood. Because you get angry after a while. Like, as a parent watching that shit, I was crying. I was very upset. I was completely mortified and taken back, you know, and to think, because I had stopped listening to R. Kelly's music for a while, you know, and I just recently was like, well, maybe I'm tripping. Once he put out the 19-minute song, I Admit, you know, I said, well, maybe I'm tripping, but I'm so glad they did this documentary so we can really see what the monster looks like, because he is absolutely a monster and a predator, and so are those that are helping him. And so I'm just so happy, Missy, that you were able to come on and tell your sister's story. And I just want to say that she's brave, you're brave, and I thank you for just even acknowledging and reaching out to me and wanting to speak on it, because as girls and little boys, we don't have that voice. And I want your sister to know that she always has a voice. Anytime she wants to come on and she wants to speak about it or talk about it and give you know, bring light to it, she is always welcome to do so. And I'm so thankful for you that you came on to do that for her on her behalf.
Thank you for having me. And I just think more people need to speak up, and a lot of people need to sometimes stop talking and listen. Just give them an ear to listen to.
Yes. And if they tell you, believe them. Believe them. It's crazy.
Because little kids don't make up stuff. They can't make up stuff like that.
Right. Right. You know, R. Kelly's older brother, Bruce, said, it's just a preference. He just likes young girls. It's a preference. It's not a preference. It's disgusting, and it's molestation, and it's pedophilia. So,
him thinking like that, it probably happened to him, and he probably did it to them.
Well, his brother, Carrie, said he did. He was also, he believed having sex with his sister as well. So, you know, he said that his sister, he hadn't spoke to her since 1993, and she called, and he told her, I forgive you. And she told him, never speak to me, reach out to me, call me again, because I don't know what you're talking about. But it's just like he said he felt like she had violated and molested him all over again, but this time she did it mentally. And so a lot of times we do victimize and violate people all over again by telling them what happened to them did not happen to them. So I just want to say thank you again for acknowledging what your sister had to go through.
Thank you for letting me be a guest on your show.
Yes, I thank you so much, Missy, again and again and 10 times over. And thank you for your support. And so, again, let her know if she wants to come on and talk about it. We are absolutely open for it. So stay on the line in case you did you want to get a reading from Jazz the Medium?
No, I'll let somebody else get an opportunity that's never had one before.
Okay. Well, listen, I'm so glad you even said that. I appreciate it. So thank you for tuning in. Thank you for the support. We're going to go ahead and take a break. Thank you again, Missy, okay?
I'm going to hang up, but I'm going to watch you online, okay?
Okay, great.
Okay.
Have a good night.
Bye, queen.
All right, you guys, listen, we're going to keep jumping in and out of this conversation all night long, but we got Jazz the Medium on the line, and I just want to say hello to her, and then we're going to take a quick break, see if she has something to add in. Hey, Jazz, how are you?
Pretty good. How about yourself?
I am well. I am well. You ready for this thing tonight?
I am over ready. Been ready all day.
You got a lot of people online tonight, Clean. You got a lot of people on the line tonight, okay? So and then we'll come right back in. All right, y'all, we're going to take a quick break. As soon as we come back, we're going right into the phone lines. We got Jazz the Medium on the line. She's going to do some reading for us tonight. I'm so excited. You listen to Soul Sessions Live.
To schedule your individual session, group, or party with me, Quatita Dean, the Ancestral Interpreter, call 513-328-0061 and get connected today. Remember, heaven is only a call away. Do you need promotion? To advertise your business, get your music played on the radio, or promote an event, reach out to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. We're looking for sponsorship. We have great packages right here. You can get anything you need for all your promotional needs. Reach out to Quatita Dean at 513-328-0061. Hey, you're listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. I am your host, Quatita Dean, and this is Soul Sessions Live. You can find me on Facebook at Quatita, Yes, I Am a Queen Dean, on IG at queens_domain1, or you can call or text 513-328-0061 to schedule your appointment today. Remember, heaven is only a call away.
All right, we are back. You're listening to Soul Sessions Live right here on the Walk with the Ancestors Radio. We are live streaming from Facebook tonight. We got Jazz the Medium in the house. We're going to go into the phone lines. But before we do that, I want to acknowledge our Facebook live people. Thank you, thank you. We did have some comments, and I just wanted to touch on to them really quick. Ms. Reynolds says they are pushing to normalize pedophilia, saying it's a natural feeling. They are absolutely trying to legalize it, calling it grown man, young boy love or something like that. I think it's a bunch of bullshit. Brita Goddess says, this is sad because things like this have taken place in my family and I have been affected by this. I always very touched when people share their story, so I really thank you for that, Bri. Also, Don Spirit Kennedy Davis says, they 4 out of 5 people have been molested. Absolutely, absolutely. And make sure you guys are checking out Dawn Spirit Kennedy Davis. She is the beautiful queen who makes the shungai oil, the different herbs, the oils and things like that. Make sure you're checking her out on Facebook. And Lauren Davis says, yes, Jazz the Medium. So, yes, Jazz the Medium is in the house. Real quick, Hot Tea, what is your thought before we jump into the phone lines? What is your thought about surviving R. Kelly?
Well, I actually think it was a great documentary. I'm glad that, you know, these ladies were able to tell their stories. And as far as I know, you know, it's a lot more that we didn't see and don't know.
Yeah.
But I just think it's just really amazing to know, like, how the kind of connection and the kind of change that he had in people's lives with his music and also with his monstrousry.
Yes. Jazz, before we go to the phone line, Jazz, what's your thought on this?
Well, I can actually say I'm a survivor myself. And like the last young lady that spoke, mine too was pushed up under the rug. And I just think that I just think it's common. And the more women that I'm connecting with and males, I'm starting to see that this is more common.
Yeah.
My issue with this R. Kelly thing is that people have known this for years, and I just feel like because of his status, it was swept up under the rug. But I'm also wondering, you know, my issue is, are we taking care of our young black girls and our black women? Who's protecting them and who's protecting us? Who's sticking up for us?
We know if they were white girls, he would have been under the jail. But they coming for his ass because they infected a young white girl with herpes and her parents are not happy about it. So maybe we'll get to see the justice, because after this documentary, I believe his days are numbered at this point. This
I'm
is when I realized
that it had to come to this, you know?
Yeah, it became a real thing to even know that men suffered through this. When I was sitting outside one day with some friends and we were drinking, and this young man walked up to my friend, and he was drunk, but he whispered in her ear. We don't know him. He whispered in her ear, and he just walked off, and she said, "Damn, that's fucked up." I said, "Well, what did he say, girl?" She said, "He said, I just need to tell somebody that boys are molested too, and it affects us too." And he just walked off like he needed to say mm-hmm. that to somebody. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, anywho, Jazz, I'm just so hype and happy to have you on. Are you ready, Queen?
Thanks for having me.
For you.
Yes,
right,
I am ready.
All right. Then let's get it. Let's go. The first four last digits. And let me just say to our beautiful people that have called in, if we can kind of be quick on it, because I want Jazz to be able to get to as many people as possible. So if you have a question or want something addressed immediately, just let her know, and then we'll go from there. All right. So last four digits is 5572.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Pretty good. How can I help you today?
Okay. Well, I'm going through this stage in my life where kind of like I feel like I'm evolving, but it's like really an emotional roller coaster also. I don't even know exactly what I want to say. I can't put it into words. I don't, I hate that I feel like this. Is there anything that I need to probably rid myself of? I don't know exactly how to put this in words. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
Okay, I'm sorry.
The first word that I got when I heard your voice was transition. So right now, your spirit is going through a transition, and that's why it probably kind of feels like you're all over the place. Mm-hmm. So what happens is that whenever we step into changes, everything kind of goes crazy before it goes dead center. So from feeling your energy, I feel like you might be like a busy young lady. Like you have your hands, you wear a lot of hats. So
yes.
I think for you, the best thing for you to do is to find time for yourself. You need time to yourself. I'm not feeling anybody around you in particular that you need to shed yourself up per se. That's not
mm-hmm.
That's not the issue. And I'm not even really sensing an issue. You're just going through some changes.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then my kid's father, which is also he's not my ex-husband yet, but we're separated.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going through this thing. He's on drugs, so my kids can't go over to his house. He has a girlfriend that doesn't like my kids, and they're 9, 8, and 5. So they're not allowed to be around her because I don't feel like that's a safe situation. And so I'm going through this thing. Like, I'm having a lot of anxiety about that because they feel as if I'm keeping them from him. And so I don't know where to go with that situation. I don't know to go left or right. You know, I don't know.
Follow your gut. Follow your gut. Listen to yourself. That's why you don't have any issues, because in tune with yourself. So you know when you feel when something is wrong, okay? So I know it's hard to keep your kids away from their father, but you have a general concern of their safety, correct?
Right. Right.
Well, then you've made the right decision. You know, you can't beat yourself over decisions that you made when you're protecting your children. I mean, they're his children too. But at the end of the day, if they're his children too, he'll get himself together. That's his problem, not yours. You just make sure you focus on your children and keeping them safe. So keep listening to yourself, because you have a good sense of discernment. And don't beat yourself up over decisions. And I know they don't understand right now, but I promise you they'll understand later. And I see this situation kind of sorting itself out sooner than you think.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's good. That's
this
good.
Is all
really
a part
really
of your
good.
Transition and growth. It's all a part of your transition and growth.
Okay. Oh, my gosh, I need to hear this so bad. I really appreciate that.
No problem. Take some time for you.
Ask who you're speaking to. Who's the lady on the line?
My name is Kiki.
Kiki, okay.
Okay, nice speaking with you, Kiki. Listen to yourself, okay, please. You know.
Yes. Thank you so much. Do you have? Are you going to put out her contact information? Do you have like your own?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll shout it out during the call, and I got some friends online, so somebody will probably stick it in the comments if you're on the live. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Great.
Thank you.
Bye bye.
Bye. Jazz, you are so freaking phenomenal, man. I love you absolutely so much. We're going to take the next caller, but before we do, go ahead and give them your contact info.
If you like to book a reading, you can hit my website up. It's www.jazzthemedium.com. You can also email me at jazzthemedium@gmail.com. I am also on Snapchat, Facebook, and Instagram under Jazz the Medium. So there's a million ways to get in contact with me.
Come on, Queen. Make sure y'all calling in to get this. Get this climb to heaven with Jazz the Medium tonight. Okay, so that number is 563-999-3422. Make sure you're checking me out next Sunday where we will have my Shira Taylor on doing her thing as well. All right, Jazz, we're going back into the phone lines. Next caller, last 4 digits is 9169. Hi, caller, who do we have on the line?
Hi, my name is Jaquil Ford.
Hi, how are you?
On with the medium.
What'd you say?
I said I'm fine. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How can I help you today?
I've just really been having a lot. I don't really have a lot going on in life right now, but my father passed away in 2016, and right now it's just like I see a lot of him, and I just kind of wanted to read him and talk to you guys.
Okay. See if we can get your father here. You said he died in 2016?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Give me just a second. Okay, so I got 3 men that stepped in for you. Let's try to go through them and see which one's your father, okay?
Okay.
Did your father have a darker complexion?
Yes, he did.
Okay. Was he a little bit on the thicker side?
No, he was slim and tall. He's very skinny.
Slim and tall? Okay, I got him. Okay, so question for you. He's making reference to me to the color red. Does that make any sense to you, the color red? I'm seeing a lot of red with him.
Yes.
Okay. What's the reference to the color red?
He wasn't really gang affiliated, but there was a bunch of guys that wore red that were like looked from the other side of town that we were lived in, and they wore it. And when he got killed, a lot of people said it was them. So maybe that's what it is. His favorite color was blue.
Okay. He is showing me a great deal of red. Was it a setup when he was killed, or y'all don't know?
That's what they say, but as far as knowing for sure, I really don't know, but that is what they say, a lot of people say. That's what's been coming to us for some years.
Okay, I was just wondering, because he's telling me he was set up by somebody that he knew. So I was just wondering. Okay. The first thing that he's telling me that he wants me to tell you, he comes in, and, you know, even though he's had his, his lifestyle, he's a very sweet man. He comes in saying that he comes in apologizing. Does that make any sense?
Yes.
He's like, you know, I'm sorry that this happened. I'm sorry I was gone too soon. he's making me feel like he had many opportunities to change, but he necessarily didn't, you know. So basically, he's kind of making me feel as if the lifestyle he had kind of led up to his death. Does that make sense?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. He's saying the word cookie in my ear. Does the word cookie make any sense to you? It could be a name. It could be something he likes, but he's definitely putting emphasis on the word cookie. Or it could be a name that sounds close to it.
I don't know. I'm trying to think.
If you can't think of nothing, we'll keep going.
I'm not really sure, but I can keep thinking about it.
Yeah. You know, sometimes things come up later, but he's definitely saying something about a cookie. Oh, goodness.
Okay.
Okay. Did you have more than one sibling with your dad? Did you have a brother?
Yes.
How old is your brother?
He is about to be 16.
Okay. He's drawing a lot of emphasis to your brother. So when he mentions your brother, he's making me feel a little worried. How's your brother doing?
He's okay. He's playing basketball. He's in another state right now.
Okay.
But I do have another brother, but he's way out. And he is 19.
He's 19?
Yes.
One of them is troubled. Which one is troubled?
The 19-year-old.
Which one looks a lot like him? Is that the 19-year-old that looks a lot like him?
No. The 16-year-old looks a lot
the
like him.
The 16-year-old looks a lot like him?
Mm-hmm.
He's worried about that 16-year-old. It's that 16-year-old. And I know you're saying that he's playing basketball and stuff like that, and he's doing good, but your father wants you to connect with him more and kind of keep an eye on him. Okay?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Just to make sure he doesn't fall into any trouble.
Okay.
You get what I'm trying to say? And then when it comes to your 19-year-old brother, he just kind of tossing his hands up like he don't listen to nobody. That's basically his feelings towards him. Like, okay, he just don't listen to nobody. It's funny because he's telling me like he don't even listen to me. Like he's trying to talk to him or give him signs, and he's just like doing what he wants to do.
Yeah, he doesn't
listen
at all.
So he's making reference to a dream. Did he come to you in a dream recently?
Yes.
Okay.
Well,
he's telling
me. Because I'm very spiritual, and I do talk to him. I do light candles for him. I do, you know, I try to communicate with him the best way I can to know that we're still, you know, we're still missing him. We're still, you know.
Can I ask you a question? Are you a, you taste like a medium. Are you a medium? Or you don't know?
No, I want to be so bad. I'm connected with my spirit world, but I don't have it down back right now.
It's okay. It's going to come in. Certain people, certain gifts, they have a certain taste to me, and you taste like a medium. So you kind of making me tingle, and you feel like a medium, but you're young. Now, you might not, I don't know how old you are in the age, but you're young in your journey. But over time, your gifts will start to flood in. Okay?
Okay.
So keep on doing what you've been doing because your gifts are going to flood in. But your dad is making reference that he did visit you in a dream before. And he's not necessarily giving me any, like, messages for you. He's making me feel as if you're doing okay, but he is kind of, you know, worried about your younger brother, the 16-year-old.
Okay.
So just kind of keep a little eye out on him.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
No problem.
All right, we'll be talking to you. All right, Jazz, we're going to go in and say, you good? You good, Jazz?
Yeah, this 2 seconds. She's powerful. I got to shake her off. Jeez. Go ahead to the next
you
call.
You need a moment?
No, I'm good. Go ahead.
Okay. You got your peoples on Facebook. Like, she's like singing your praises, and I'm just so grateful to her. Is Lauren?
Yeah, that's my boo.
Yeah, so she's like, you know, singing your praises. So Thank you, but we're going to go ahead on. Last four digits is 9494.
You need a moment.
Hi, caller, who do you have on?
Hello.
Hi, who do you have on?
Lauren. You said your name is Lauren?
Where are you calling from?
Mario
phone.
Oh, is y'all in the same house?
I'm watching you on my phone and then calling you from his phone.
Girl, I'm not going to do this with you.
Echo.
I'll let you talk to Jazz. Go ahead.
Okay, so you said your name is Lauren again?
No, Gwen.
Gwen. Okay, hi, Gwen.
Yes. How are you?
How can I help you? I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. I just want a general reading.
Okay. The first word that comes to me when I think about you is money. And Spirit wants me to I got a question for you. So in reference to finances, are there some issues there?
Not necessarily, but I'm dealing with some situations in regard to, money.
Gotcha. Okay, so when I tapped into you and I connected with you, for me with money, I see a door, and when the door opens, it kind of shows me amount of money or whether something like that. But when your door opens, it's like I get the word floodgate. So I'm thinking that means that whatever you're taking care of is going to be okay really
mm-hmm.
soon, maybe even sooner than you think. And I
mm-hmm.
also see a small increase in your finances. So do you have a business? Are you working on something business-wise?
I'm working on getting a business. I already have everything already planned out, but once everything works out the way I need it to work out, then I'm just going to go ahead and launch it, everything that I've been planning on doing.
Okay. So the question I'm getting from Spirit is, what's the hold up? Is it something that's out of your control, or you're a perfectionist?
I'm kind of a perfectionist, and then finances has a lot to do with it. And then the situation that I'm dealing with now in terms of my husband's death. So I really don't want to, speak too much on that, via live. But
right.
Quatita knows a lot about, what's going on in regard to that matter.
Gotcha. This year is going to be a good year for you, okay? Things are going to
mm-hmm.
pan out for you. I see doors opening for you. I see things smoothing out for you, okay?
Okay.
So that's my message for you in regards to that. So everything is going to pan out just fine. And
okay.
I do see some increases. And I even see something coming. So that's what I have with that.
Okay.
Did you want to ask me anything else real quick?
One quick question. Is there any habits that I need to give up?
Are you a smoker?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one right there. Go ahead and kick it.
Okay.
Ooh, got it in the butt.
Go ahead and kick that habit right on now. Kick it on over the head.
All right. I appreciate you.
Right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Sam, right. I'll be talking to you. We got Jazz the Medium on the line. Make sure you call it in. That is 563-999-3422. Jazz, one more time, tell them how they can reach you for a private session.
You want to book a private reading with me, you can hit my website up at www.jazzthemedium.com. You can email me at jazzthemedium@gmail.com. You can also hit me up on Facebook, Instagram, and Snapchat under the same name.
All right, we're going right on back into phone lines. If you're good, we're going in. You ready?
I'm good.
Okay, last four digits is 1453. Hi, caller. Who do we have on the line?
That's me.
That's you?
Yeah.
Hi, Queen.
What's your name?
This is Dawn Spirit.
You said your name is Dawn?
This is Dawn Spirit.
Oh,
okay. How are you?
Me?
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to let you talk
to your speaker. That's so rude. Hi.
You're the one that, so you make the oils, huh?
Yes, ma'am, I do.
Okay, I'm going
to have
to find you.
I was just listening in.
I love some oils. Did you have any questions for me or anything like that?
I've been connecting with my ancestors lately and trying to really go in more than I normally have, and wanted to know if any one of them had a message for me.
As a matter of fact, I got a lady here. She's an older woman. She feels very motherly, grandmotherly. Like, she's not tall. I feel like she's a shorter
mm-hmm.
woman. She may have been a woman that went to church. Let me see what else I can.
What complexion is she?
She's like a, yeah, I feel as if she's like a brown skin. She's not really dark, but she's not light either. So she's kind of somewhere in between. I'm not always precise on complexions,
mm-hmm.
but she doesn't feel
okay.
really dark to me. She feels brown skin. And also, I
mm-hmm.
feel like her voice is very light, very soft.
I don't know who that can be.
Let me see what else I can get from her.
Do you have an initial, or what side of the family, if it's my dad's side or my mother's side?
She's giving me a T name, and I almost feel like I'm hearing Terry. And she might have had something with her throat.
Mary.
Okay. Who's Mary?
My grandmother, my
okay.
father's mother.
Okay. Do you know of anything that she may have had with her throat?
Yeah, she used to smoke, and she had to stop. So if it's not Mary, then it's Rose, but I think it's Mary.
I think I'm really feeling like it's Mary.
Okay.
I really feel like it's Mary. Question though, who had a cancer, Mary or Rose?
Both of them did, but more so Mary. Well,
okay. I'm talking to Mary. Most definitely talking to Mary.
Okay.
Mary just comes in to give her love. But she's also making me feel this. There's a recent death in the family, or it can also mean that you may be going through something that could be kind of keeping you down a little bit. So I feel a sadness from her. Do you know where that could come from?
We did have a relative that died recently, but yeah, her niece did. But
okay.
Her picture keeps jumping off of my altar. I have a family altar.
Mm-hmm.
And her picture keeps jumping off. She's in that picture with my mother and my first grandchild. And that
she
picture
wants
keeps
you to know
falling
that she's,
off my altar.
Yeah, she wants you to know that she's here.
Okay.
So that's just her giving you confirmation that whatever type of work that you're doing with your family altar is working. That's just all confirmation.
Okay.
You know, that's thanks, that's love. So whenever they have pictures on their altar and they're kind of telling me to tell you that she comes and she visits you and she's there.
Okay. Well, thank you so much.
One more question. She's. Do you have something gold on your altar?
Which one?
I'm just
I have
curious.
Four altars.
I don't know. She's just bringing my attention to something gold.
Mm.
Something gold. It could be a piece of jewelry maybe, or something gold in color. I feel like it's a smaller object.
Okay. Well, I have four
do you
different
have...
altars.
Okay. or do you have something of hers that's gold? She's putting emphasis on this gold idol.
I don't know. I do have a picture of, I mean, I do have her, I have a silver bracelet that she had that wasn't working that I didn't get fixed yet.
Okay, is it on your altar?
No, it's not. It's in my jewelry box. But I do have some ancestry money on my altar that's gold.
Okay.
That she needs.
She wants you to until you get it. Hello.
I'm sorry.
Can you hear me?
Mm-hmm. What did you say?
I think she wants you to until you get that piece of jewelry fixed. I don't know how much traffic you have in your house, but you feel comfortable with setting it on your altar.
Oh no, it's fine to have it in my home. Just my husband and I and my godson is visiting, so it'd be safe.
Okay. Gotcha. Yeah,
oh,
I think she wants you to set it up.
I do have a ring. It's not on my altar, but my grandparents' 30th anniversary ring that they gave me, that's gold, that they gave me.
Oh. Got it. I just see a piece of gold on your altar.
And I wear it all the time.
I
never take it. And I'm by my altar a lot, so maybe that's what she's seeing.
Yeah, probably that.
Yeah.
I just see gold.
Gold and tall, too.
Huh?
You see it?
Say it was a small gold something.
Yep. Shows it sitting on an altar, so I don't know if she wants you to set it up there for a little bit or whatnot. I'm not too sure.
Okay.
Before I let you
okay.
go, Don,
am I giving them a...
Don, can you give people your contact for your oils and herbs or your YouTube channel before I let you go, Don?
Sure, yeah. It's Dawn, D-A-W-N, Spirit, S-P-I-R-I-T. And you can just put in shungite oil if you can't find me. Put shungite oil in Dawn Spirit. Shungite is spelled S-H-U-N-G-I-T-E, a magical oil. You could tell it what you wanted to do. It also heals you. Heals illnesses, blocks negative energy, and you just hold the oil and put it on your chakras and tell it what you wanted to do. My email address is dawnspiritk@icloud.com.
Thank you so much. Make sure you
You're
put
welcome,
that
sister.
Up on like a comment. Make sure you put that in the comment section for me as well, Dawn.
Okay. Thank you so much. I greatly appreciate it, everyone.
Yes, no problem.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you as well.
Okay,
all
queens,
right.
Y'all have a blessed evening. I'm going to stay on and watch you guys.
Okay, you too.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I love shungite. Shungite's a very powerful crystal.
Oh, yeah, and that's what I have around my neck. I went and got me. Break really
Hello?
Quick. Give you a moment to ramp
oh,
back
no, I'm
up.
Good.
You're doing so.
I'm
you're
good.
Doing so well, sir. Your energy is
Thank
great.
You.
I'm
Quatita?
Yeah.
Out on me. I don't know what's going on.
Can you hear me, Jazz?
I can hear you, but you keep going in and out. It's weird.
I know. That's what I said. I said it keeps cutting in and out for some reason. But we're going to take a break. We'll be right back, okay?
Awesome. Okay.
Okay. Sorry, you guys. I know. I don't know why it's cutting in and out like that, but make sure you're checking out Jazz the Medium. I think it's at www.jazzthemedium.com. We'll be right back. This is Soul Sessions Live. Hey, you're listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. I am your host, Quatita Dean, and this is Soul Sessions Live. You can find me on Facebook at Quatita, Yes, I Am a Queen Dean, on IG at queens_domain1, or you can call or text 513-328-0061 to schedule your appointment today. Remember, heaven is only a call away. Do you need promotion to advertise your business, get your music played on the radio, or promote an event?
Reach out to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. We're looking for sponsorship. We have great packages right here. You can get anything you need for all your promotional needs. Reach out to Quatita Dean at 513-328-0061.
All right. Thank you for joining us. This is Soul Sessions Live. You're listening to A Walk with the Ancestors Radio. Make sure you're checking us out each and every Wednesday and Sunday night. That is 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We live stream from Instagram on Wednesdays and from Facebook on Sundays. Make sure you're also checking out A Walk with Prime. That's on A Walk with the Ancestors TV on YouTube, where we take cold case, hot case, different cases, and we give our take on them. All right, we have Jazz the Medium on the line. We're going to jump right back on to this thing. Let's get her back in here. Jazz, you ready?
I'm ready.
All right. So we got last four digits, 7043. We have on the line, Tom.
Hello.
Hi, who do we have?
Shanice.
Hi, Shanice. What can I do for you today?
We're good. I'm good.
That's
all right.
Good.
You got a question for Jazz?
I'm sorry.
You're on with Jazz the Medium.
How can I help you, honey?
Yes. I just wanted to get a little over our reading.
My attention is being drawn to, is there something going on in your love life?
No.
My attention is being drawn there. You're not dating right now?
I was, but we're no longer together.
It ain't been long since y'all been split.
Huh?
It hasn't been long since y'all been split.
No, it hasn't.
Okay. How you been feeling?
Fine.
The energy don't feel like it. Give me a second. Because you sound fine and you say you feel fine, but your energy is just, it's all over the place, honey. Give me a chance. Give me a second. Hold on.
Okay.
Let's see what's going on here. The message that I'm basically getting from you, it's the kind of stick to your guns and the kind of stay to it. There is like not much I can say to you that should be
said. You
say
it's playing on the TV.
It's something in your background. Yeah.
Yes. Look on my controller.
Okay, the message I'm kind of getting for you is to stay strong. I feel like, and I know you say you feel like you're okay, but I feel like something's not right. You know what I mean? So the message I'm getting for you is just to stay strong. Huh?
Something not right as far as what?
Like I don't know. Like maybe there's something that's going into your, there's something going on in your life that's just not going the way you want it to go. If that's the way I can put it. But maybe there's something you're not happy about. Mm-hmm. You know, or maybe you're not happy overall right now. That's how I feel. Like, and I know you say you're okay, but it just doesn't feel like you're all right. You know what I mean? Like, if I could right now, I'd give you a hug. That's how I feel. So,
Well, definitely to keep your energy up so Jazz can connect with your energy, Quinn.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, you
so,
said make sure I keep my energy up.
Yeah, I'm connected, but
your energy is just not matching what you're saying. So what I would, my advice would be for you.
We did, yes. I broke up with him, but it's like we cool. It's just not something happened to him coming to my house, and it just kind of like caused a lot of drama.
Mhm. Yeah. Well, the term I'm getting for you is to stay strong and to stand your ground. You know, and to be diligent. Are you? Do you know where I am on Facebook?
Okay.
I don't do this often, but I want you to inbox me, and then I'll give you your message on the inbox. I think this is more personal. Okay.
Okay.
So yeah, we'll do it that way.
Tonight?
Yeah, inbox me tonight, and I'll answer you tonight after the show. So the show's not over till 10, okay?
Okay. Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Shanae. Is it a
good... No problem.
Uh-oh. Wait a minute. What'd you say, Shanae?
Hello? I said, is it a good message, or...
It's just a message. I don't deliver bad news, nah.
Okay.
You know, I have a message for you. I'm getting my privacy signed. I'm going to inbox it to you. And it's kind of hard to talk to you live because you closed off. So I thought maybe if we talk more privately, I can open you up a little bit to give you I want to give you a message. I can't really get to you. You get what I'm saying? Okay.
All right.
No problem.
That's kind of what I was meaning about her keeping her energy up, because sometimes it's kind of hard, you know what I mean, when the energy is not where we kind of be. But
and some people, they're afraid that you're going to say too much. So I try to be as general as possible when I talk to people, because I ain't going to put nobody out there, you know what I mean? That's not my intent.
I definitely understand. We got somebody, 3920. What do we have on the line? You're on the phone with Jazz?
Hello?
Hi. What do we have?
Can I help?
This is Hodari. I'm sorry. I didn't realize who I was talking to. You kind of caught me off guard. But my real name is actually Kim. Say what now?
You're on with Jazz the Medium. How can she help you today?
Hi, Jazz. Nice to meet you. I just had a couple of questions about my personal life and the path I am I on the right track as far as seeking my own business. And my mom and dad has, like, been on my mind and in my head even recently. So I wanted to know what was going on with that.
Okay. Let's start with your business. I'm getting the word fear. Are you having some fear surrounding that? Like, what's are you nervous about something, or?
Yeah, I'm kind of nervous. I took on the job last year during the third quarter with the post office. So, and I went back in simply because so I can purchase a home, because I was told by my real estate instructor that I should have a W-2 job until after I obtain the purchase of my home. So coming out of the regular 9-to-5, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm kind of fearful of that, because I've had my own business before, but which was home improvement. And when the market crashed, that kind of set me and my family back very bad.
Gotcha. Is that something that you're looking to go back into?
Not at the moment. What I'm looking into going into is obtaining my independent dealership license to sell cars, and to go back and take the state exam. So that's, I'm kind of nervous about the state exam for real estate, because I failed it when I first took it earlier last year.
For you, I'm going to tell you this. Your nerves and your fears are the only thing in your way. You're fine.
Okay.
Sometimes we let
sometimes we let our, you know, sometimes we look at failures the wrong way and we let them hinder us when they should be mm-hmm. they should be looked at lessons so we can achieve and do better.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I like your mindset. You'll be just fine.
But yeah, I'm ready to go get it, man, because I'm tired of dealing with corporate America, and I'm not happy at the post office because management stuck and they keep you under unnecessary stress, and I'm like, I might as well just work for myself. Mm-hmm. And I come from entrepreneurs on both sides of the family, so like I say, I'm just ready to go get it and just
yeah.
shoot for the stars.
I can definitely feel your drive. It's your fears. Like, when you talk to me about it, I kind of connect to your feelings, and I feel a little anxious. Like, I get little butterflies in my belly, like, oh, Lord, what if something goes wrong with this? When sometimes failure is necessary for us to learn, and it makes us better
mm-hmm.
people. And it's that whatever happened in the housing crisis back in 2008, 2009, whenever all that stuff happened, it made you a stronger person. You get what I'm saying? So
mm-hmm. yeah.
in that aspect, you'll be fine, but you got to work on those fears. I tell you, fear is like the lowest vibrational frequency, and it can really hold you back. You got to get over that hump and just know that it's okay.
Okay.
All right. Mm-hmm. Well, thank
now.
You for
that, Ms.
Kadari.
Okay.
Was y'all good on it?
I think he just wanted a quick message from his one of your parents.
Yeah, both of them. Have really been on my mind, and a lot of times I can hear them. Just depends on what the situation is. We just had a death on both sides of the family, and these was like uncles
okay.
that I was dealing, you know, had dealings with coming up. And when my parents died and my grandmother, my uncle Troy, he was a famous gospel singer. I would call him from time to time just for some guidance.
Mm-hmm.
And when I first came back to Atlanta, I went to go see him a few times, you know. So other than going through what I'm going through physically and the depression that I've been in, you know, that hit me hard, you know.
Well, you just
Understood.
Gave me the message that your father had for you. Your father kind of stepped through. He's just telling me you've been down. So he wants you to pick yourself
mm-hmm.
up. Just real quick, do you belong to, are you religious? Do you belong to like a church or something like that?
I was raised in a church, but no, I follow, I'm a spiritual person. I follow.
Okay. So whatever you do, he wants you to dive deeper down into your spirituality. Of course, he's telling me to tell you to go to church. So, but that was probably his way of dealing with things. So I think
uh-huh.
if you're spiritual and you're into your spirituality, that's what you need to tap into,
mm-hmm.
okay? So for
mm-hmm.
you, since you're depressed, I mean, you need to start journaling. If you don't journal yet, just kind of write out how you feel. Get it out. Don't
mm-hmm.
let it sit in there. Don't suppress it. I don't care if you say you want to go hang yourself or something like that. Just write it all out and get it all out, and don't let it stay in. Okay. So
okay.
Right, and that's the word I'm getting for you.
All
okay,
right.
And that's one of my gifts too.
Yep, so that's the message I'm getting for you. Very important.
We said a lot
I heard
of
someone else say something.
Thank you.
Say what now?
Oh
God, she
was
just telling you thank
Uh-oh.
You. These calls, they got to be very brief. It's a lot of people waiting. I'm sorry about that. But just make sure you're
yeah.
journaling, okay?
We didn't got any clicked off. We love you,
okay.
Adari. We know you can still hear us, so. Yeah, because you got a lot of people. You still have, like, 12 callers on the line, Jazz. So,
yay!
Yes, so I want to move very quickly for you. Last four digits is 2524. Hi, who do we have on the line with Jazz?
Hi, this is Elizabeth.
Hello,
hi, Elizabeth.
Hi.
How can I help you?
I'm just calling to see what Spirit has to say.
How you been feeling, Miss Elizabeth?
Physically or spiritually?
Both.
Spiritually, you know, more connected. Physically, I've been going a little bit, you know, I'm getting over some illnesses.
Gotcha. The word that I'm getting for you is, and I know you said spiritually you've been coming more into, but the word I'm getting for you is self-love. You know, so I'm feeling like there's a need for you to love on yourself a little bit more. I don't know if that means, I don't know if you haven't had much time to spend with yourself or time to kind of make yourself up and, you know, do for yourself. I'm not sure, but that's definitely a strong word and a strong sense that I'm getting for you. Like you need to become more in tune with you, which you're kind of working on through your spirituality, but that should be an aim. You get what I'm trying to say?
Yes.
Yeah. So I'm getting that you need to do more for you. Maybe even, I always tell people take a vacation if you can, or just get away for a little bit. Just take some time to yourself to really love on yourself. You know, if you can afford to get yourself something you like, or just do something nice for yourself. You got children?
Okay. I do. Huh? I have two.
Yeah. And I know sometimes with kids, it's kind of hard for us mothers to kind of put ourselves first or do something for ourselves. So your definite message is that you need to lean more into loving and appreciating yourself and pour more into yourself.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank
All
you.
Right. Thank you.
All right. We really appreciate you. And thank you for calling in for support. Have a good night, Queen, okay?
You too, Queen.
Thank you. All right. Going on. I want to make sure, because it's so hard for me to keep up. Last four digits is 1274. 1274. Who we have on the line?
Hi, Queen. This is Dirty Tha. How are you doing?
Good. How are you, Miss Teresa?
I'm fine. Hi, Jazz.
Hey.
What can I do for
you
today?
Yeah. I wanted to know if my brother had a message for me. He's been on my mind a lot. He's been gone maybe 23 years, and today was like his anniversary that he passed away. And I just feeling for some reason. So I'm just calling to see if he's got a message for me.
So tell me, I got somebody here, but it's not a very strong connection. Who has cancer? Who has had cancer?
My mother had breast cancer.
Your mother had breast cancer?
Uh-huh.
Is your mom deceased or she's still here?
Yeah, she's deceased.
Okay. I think I got your mom.
That's okay, too.
So, unfortunately, all the time, I can't always control who brings the messages. And right now your mom wants to come in, and she's just showering you with a whole lot of love.
Oh, my God.
Tell me, she's making me feel as if you had a moment recently. You know how, like, every once in a while we might have a moment, like, I had one the other day. I think somebody said something about my mom, and it was just like a I miss her moment. But
Well, today after church, me and my daughters went out to eat. And we were talking about my brother, and I just broke down in tears. And he's been gone 23 years, you know, so I really had a moment. I was telling him a story of, you know, me giving him a gift for his birthday, and it just brought back a lot of memories and stuff. So I had a moment today.
So question, and you can help me see if this makes sense. I see a blue and white striped shirt. Did he own a shirt like that, or did somebody have a shirt like that? It's like a short sleeve blue and white striped shirt.
Picture with him with a blue shirt on, with him playing his saxophone.
Okay. How did your brother pass?
We believe he had AIDS.
Was he a darker complexion?
Mm-hmm.
I got him. He's here.
Oh,
he's here. I got him. Okay, yeah, he's here.
Awesome.
Because he's kind of showing me an image of him, and he's got on a blue shirt. He's got on, like, a white hat. Very nice gentleman. Very nice gentleman. Very happy. I can't explain it, but he came in. He was like, hey, hey. Like,
real bubbly.
That type of energy.
Real bubbly. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, real bubbly. Like, hey, hey.
Yes.
Like, that type of energy. he's also making me feel like he knew how to have a good time, you know.
Yes. Yes.
Very fun
definitely.
And loving. He was,
yes.
He tells me. He would have been, he was the favorite uncle. He would have been the favorite uncle.
He was. Mm-hmm. We talked about that today. Yes.
He would have been the favorite. He just sends his love. I mean, and he's over the top with it. He's like, he's blowing kisses to everybody. And he's just sending lots of love. I get what you mean when you say the saxophone. He's kind of showing me that. Was he a good saxophone player? Because he's almost making me feel like he wasn't. Like he wasn't all that. Is it something he did in school or did he do it professionally? He was a good player?
He was definitely a good player, yes.
Oh, look at you. Now playing yourself. Let me see. Let me see.
I think you should get
modest. Yeah.
I just want to ask a quick question, if I may. Can I just ask a question?
Uh-huh.
Is there something about a dog? Does somebody have a dog?
He had a lot of dogs, or I had a dog recently passed 2 years ago.
Was it brown?
It was a Shih Tzu. She was brown and white.
Okay. Your dog came through.
Oh, my gosh. That was my heart.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
I think that's what Quatita was picking up on.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, she's a cute little dog.
Oh, my
you
gosh. She was my heart. Oh, gosh.
Well, your brother sends his love.
Awesome.
And, he says thank you.
Yes. We really appreciate you so much.
That is just great. That's great to hear. I'm glad he's okay. And he's watching over me.
Yeah.
Because I feel him. I can feel him. I definitely
Absolutely.
Feel him. One more question I've got to ask you before I close. I've been off of work. I had back surgery in June of last year. And it was a bad back surgery. So I put it for Social Security, disability. And I have been waiting and waiting. I know it takes a long time. But I need to know if it's going to be approved, or do I have to go find another job? You know, I just need to know.
Is this your first time applying, or have you appealed yet?
This is the first time I've applied, and I have a lawyer also.
For some reason, I'm getting the number two. So sometimes with Social Security, they might not approve you the first time. You have to appeal it. And you may get lucky the second round.
Okay.
You probably know something around mid-February. I got the number two as well, but I didn't know if it was February or what that is. So definitely understand.
Yeah, me too. I was wondering that. So it could be either or. Or you might have to go through another round of appeal. I just don't see it being successful the first time.
Okay.
But it's okay, you know, appeal is always great. Don't reapply, appeal it, okay?
Okay. That sounds
all
good.
All right, thank you
and
so much,
and if you need
Queen.
To take it all away.
Sounds good.
Definitely.
Thanks, guys. Love you, Queen.
Yes.
Thank you. All right.
All right, Jazz, you good?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm sorry. I got my three-year-old. She just came out of... I had her on YouTube, and she's bored now, so I'm giving her something to do real quick. Here you go, love.
Okay.
You're welcome.
You're
okay,
good.
I'm ready.
Yo, twin, that's your twin, girl.
Girl, yes. Right. I love her to pieces.
Last four digits is 1688. Who do we have on the line, caller?
Therese.
Hi, Tariq. You are with Jazz and Mia.
How you doing?
Pretty good. How can I help you?
I'm trying to figure out how I'm gonna deal with two situations, and I know I talked to Miss Quatita a long time ago about it, but it's been weighing on my mind real heavy, and I'm really just to the point where I'm not trying to go back to my old ways and be petty about it, but I've been battling with that.
Does one of these situations have to do with a relationship?
One of my kids' dads, yes. Well, both of them are about my kid's dad, but one of them is towards my oldest girl's dad.
Okay, question. Do you still kind of deal with one of them?
No.
Okay. Who's I'm picking up another feminine energy in the picture. Who's the other feminine energy?
I'm not sure.
Is there somebody you're not getting along with?
No.
Okay.
Well, two of my kids' daddies, their other child's mom, I mean, we get along fine, so that's not an issue.
Mm-hmm. Is there somebody in the family you ain't getting along with, or everything cool over there? I just really feel heavily like there's a feminine energy that just.
Well, okay. My youngest girl's dad, I pretty much said some things to his sister a while back. Maybe that's what that is. Because
okay.
I have four baby daddies.
Okay. This is what I'm getting for you is very general. And the general message that I'm getting for you is, and I'm sorry, but are you a little aggressive?
I am.
Are you aggressive? So I'm just kind of picking up that a lot of the issues you have stems from your approach to things.
Yeah, I've been
trying
to.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've been trying to. Like, handle that and not try to pop off so quick. At times,
but how
I try to think
it?
About. I sometimes I just don't say anything, and that's what kills me, because it's like I have to try to be in between. Like, if I say something, I have to watch how I say it and not just come off so strong and rude, because I.
Yeah. Okay, so my question for you, if you don't say anything, then how do you release it? It's coming out somewhere.
That's why it bothers me.
I just feel like it's coming out in some way. So the funny thing is, and I say this lightly, I don't want you to think that I'm pointing the finger or being accusatory, but I say this lightly. Like, you're saying you don't want to go back to being petty, but I just feel like you being petty when you say you don't want to go back to being petty. You get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
And I like you already.
It's like I'm so, like, with my oldest girl dad, like, I'm so angry because I've heard the apologies, I've heard this and I've heard that, but to me it's like that doesn't mean shit to me if you're not gonna step up and do what you say you're going to do when it comes to her. And I just want to know, like, why?
The only thing that,
like,
you can do is focus on the things that you can control. You can't control what that man do. You cannot make him do what he's supposed to. You cannot make anybody do what they're supposed to do. The only person's actions that you can control are your own. Yeah, you
have
to.
And I mean, I haven't, but it's like, because recently, I'm not going to lie, like, I had a dream the night before last about the situation. And I don't know where it came from. I don't know if it's because it was on my mind, but the dream was like, him actually saying that he apologized and he know he ain't been there. So I don't know if that's just a way for him realizing, like,
that
he knows.
I just feel like that was your dream. That's something that you probably want him to do. you know, but I don't, you know, from his energy, I just don't, he got some growing to do, you know, and I'm just being honest with you. But the only thing that you can focus on is what you can control, you know, and once you let go of the things that you can't control, things would be a lot better for you. You can't control everything. You can't make that man be a father to his child, but you can control the way you parent your child. You get what I'm saying? But I mean, there's other things, like you can go to child support or take them to court, you know, if that'll work for you. But what can you do?
You know, I'll just say this to you real quick, Ms. Tareen. I don't think you're in no danger of him be supposed to do.
Say it again, Queen, I couldn't hear.
In any danger of he going to ever step up and do what he's supposed to do, at least not for the next 5 years, I don't see that. Do you agree with that, Jazz?
I agree. That's why I'm trying to get her to look at it from a different perspective.
So should I just not even try to have his mom involved? Because I don't know. Should I just not even just do anything pertaining to him and his family? Should just let it go and...
I mean, are you talking about cutting all of them off for his mistakes?
Well, I mean, I opened up a door for her to be invited to her birthday party that I have planned. But it's like, I don't know if I should do that anyway. I mean, I don't know if I should just give her the details on it. Like,
she didn't do anything. She's just the grandmother. So why does she not deserve to come to her grandbaby birthday party because her son cutting up?
Yeah,
that's just
I agree.
What I'm saying. You can't take your hurt or your anger out on him towards his whole family. Now if they all over there tripping, that's different. But if it's just him, they shouldn't have to pay for his actions. Yeah, it's creating a lot of drama in that. That's all I'm saying. You know. You got to cut that off.
Okay.
All right, cool. Okay.
All righty. Thank you.
All right, well, it's going to be all right. It's going to work itself out. Don't even stress yourself out about it. We thank you for calling in, though. Love you, love you.
I have one more question.
Yes.
Okay.
What about my love life?
Your love life, again, is general. It's general. I mean, I feel like your love life is shifty. And, again, I think it all has to do with your approach. So I think if you really sit down and do some self-work and kind of work on that aspect of yourself, I think that it'll ease up a little better. I'm telling you, your message is very simple and it's all the same. It's that aggression.
Okay.
It's that emotion. It's that self-work you need to work on.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what's causing a lot of issues.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
All righty.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Bye.
All right, guys. We got 19 minutes left in the show, and I want to make sure you can at least get to a couple more people, okay? So,
okie dokie.
I'm going to go here to, and if I've already come to you and I come to you, just let me know because there's so many numbers, I can't keep track. 5081 is the last four digits, 5081. Who do we have on the line?
Hi, this is Yolanda.
Hi, Yolanda.
Hi, Jess. How are you?
Pretty good. What can I do for you?
I feel like I can't catch a break. I just need an overall, what you see.
You're right, girl. You got something going on a little bit of every aspect of your life. I just want to hug you right now.
Man.
Yeah. And you know, you have to go through this stuff. I just don't. I see a breakthrough coming through soon, but a lot of these things are even too personal for me to mention, but you have to go through some of these things, you know?
Mm-hmm.
But one thing that you can do is look at it positively. Don't look at it like a whole bunch of
messed up things happening to you, look at it like a rebuild, okay? So in order for you to rebuild something, you got to break some things down, right?
Right.
So I see some new things coming, but right now you're purging out of some old things. And, mm-hmm. I mean, I see a lot of things leaving. I see people leaving. What's going on in your love life?
It's all over the place.
Yeah, see, that situation right there, and I don't know, I hope it's not a husband. If it is, I'm sorry. I just kind of see that situation kind of weeding itself out.
Mm-hmm.
But I see a lot of newness coming, too.
Okay.
So put on your big girl panties and get your spirits up. Stay positive about it, please. Things are going to start shifting for you soon, but in order for you to have better in your life, you got to get rid of the old stuff.
Mhm. I'm finding that out.
Yep. So stuff is going to start naturally leaving. If you want to make it quicker, kick some of that shit out the way. That's all I'm saying. So new stuff will start coming in, and you'll start feeling better. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Bonda.
All right. Thank you, ladies.
Yes, ma'am. All right. Good. We're gonna go on down to the next person. Again, if I've already come to you, please just let me know. It's so many numbers, I really can't keep track. 0969. Who do you have on the line?
Yes. Hi, my name
Hi.
Is Kim. Hello.
What's your name?
Kim.
Kim? Yeah. How can I help you, Kim?
I just want to overall read it, and then I want to know if this boy named Terrence Smith come in.
Okay. Who was Terrence Smith to you? That's your friend?
Yeah, he was like, I caught him my no matter what. Like, he was just somebody I always talked to and stuff. I always to tell stuff to and stuff like that. The way I came up with
him. Yeah, I'm familiar with who he was, his backstory.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Jazz, tell her about it. Tell her about it.
Okay, so basically. So basically, one night I went to sleep and I had a dream. And in my dream, a young man came to me. I asked him what was his name, and I thought he said E. And his name was E, but he was upset, and he was just like, man, it done set me up and killed me. He was like, I got a baby on the way. I got a daughter. You know, what am I going to do? What am I going to tell my mama? He was just so upset about what happened, and he just didn't know what to do. So basically one of the things that I do for people who have transitioned to haven't crossed over yet was I help them cross over. So basically – I helped this gentleman cross over, but I had no idea who he was. Well, the next morning when I woke up, I'm watching the news, and they're talking about a young man was killed over in Walnut Hills in front of the little store over there. And when they showed his picture, that was the gentleman that was in my dream. So I think instead of him saying E, he said T, because the dream names sound very muffled to me. My name is T. So... that's how I became familiar with him, is he kind of popped up in my dream. And that happens sometimes when somebody dies. They'll come to me in a dream to help them cross over, and then I'll watch it on the news the next day. So he's one of my souls that came to me. you know what? I'm picking up that he wasn't the most innocent, but he was a good guy overall. He was well-liked.
Yes.
I'm also feeling like he's showing me items. So, look, don't judge me, but I feel like he may have had sticky fingers. I'm getting like he may have been a booster. Like he might have had sticky fingers, and I feel like he's pretty good at it. Okay.
Yeah, he got real sticky fingers.
And I also feel like kept a little weed here and there. You know, he had his little things that he did, but he wasn't a bad kid. He was just surviving. You know, he wasn't out here trying to harm nobody or nothing like that.
I do feel very strongly as if his death was very senseless, and I also feel like he was killed by somebody that he knows. Because he keeps saying, like, I just can't believe they did that to me. Why would they do that to me? That's the kind of feel he's giving me. So I haven't kept up. I don't like people like me. We don't like to watch the news. It's just too much. So I don't know if they caught his killer, but I definitely feel like it's somebody that he knows.
It's three people that they saying did it, but I personally feel like somebody that he knew had something to do with it, if you get what I'm saying.
Gotcha. Gotcha. He is also talking about, he said there's a lot of drama surrounding his death, a lot of fighting with family.
Yeah. Yeah.
And he's also drawing my attention to a young lady that's causing a lot of, that he feel like is hurt. Because she's hurt, she's causing a lot of trouble. So I feel
mom.
Like he may have a child by this person. Oh, see, yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, the mother of his child.
So, okay, I know you said they're child buddies, but he's making me feel like y'all connection was, y'all were just friends?
Nah, we was more than friends.
Okay, because he's making me seem like that connection was a little bit deeper than y'all just being friends, okay? Shit, he said, he's like, I'm gone now. I ain't got nothing to lose, hey. You know, he's funny. So I can't hold you too long because we only got a few minutes left, but he does definitely send his love to you, okay?
Okay. And can you just tell me about my love life? Because I just need to know, like, I'm scared to just talk to people now. Like, not only him, like, I'm talking to somebody else and they passed away too. Like, I'm just so scared to talk to anybody. Miss Quatita done told me somebody's trying to talk to me just to do it to me. So I just be scared to talk to people now. I don't even know what to do. I talk to this boy now and I'm even scared to talk to him a little bit. Like,
how old are you?
I'm 22.
Okay, so my question is, what type of people are you drawn to talking to?
Street boys. Because
my thing is this, if you're talking to these young men that are out here in the streets and you know that there's a chance that they can have that type of thing happen to them, that's what you're going to get sometimes. So my message to you is, change the type of people you're talking to. You're a beautiful girl. I can already feel your energy. You're beautiful. Go get you a dude with a regular old job.
Yeah.
Don't get you a dude with a regular old 9-to-5 that get up and go to work every day that can actually do something for you. You know, I know those little street guys, they fun, but look what happens sometimes. You're a smart girl. Okay?
We got 10 minutes left, Jazz, and I want to be able to get you to one more person at least.
Okay.
Thank you.
No problem, sweetie.
Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good
night. All right. We're going to go to one more person, 4293. Who do we have on the line? Hi, caller. Who do we have? 4293. Hello? I don't know. I'm not getting a response. Sometimes they forget this, their number. 6320.
Fuck what another motherfucker say about you. You hear me? Guess what? She believes in you. I believe in you.
Hello?
I believe in you too. Yeah. You believe in you. Yes. Preach it.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm hello.
Yes,
yes.
Ma'am.
Hello. Blessings. Blessings.
Who are we speaking with?
This is Stephanie.
Hey, Stephanie. How can I be of assistance to you today?
Yes, I was just trying to get a general reading.
Okay. When was the last? Have you been anywhere recently? Like out of state or out of town or something?
Not recently, no.
I don't know why, but I feel like I get a feeling of being bottled up, and I really feel like you need to loosen up, get out.
Okay.
Does that make any sense to you? Like, have you been working a lot, maybe?
I have.
Okay. Yeah. it's time for you to plan a vacation. That's what I feel the most. I feel like it's much needed. I like your energy, by the way. I feel like you need to clear your mind a little bit. You know what I mean? Get away. I am really feeling like you need a vacation right now, and that's what spirit is sticking out to me the most. Something else talking now. Hold on. Have you been anxious or nervous about something coming up? I'm trying to understand what this feeling is. Is something coming up that you're nervous about?
Not necessarily. Just some situation.
Something's coming up. And you ain't got nothing big coming. No move, no job change, nothing. I feel like a change coming. Quatita, can you hone in on this one? Do you feel a change around her?
I wouldn't even say a change, but I do feel like there's possibly something keep coming up. They do keep wanting me to go to the next, two or three months out from now. But it feels like the change is something that she doesn't know about. It feels unexpected to me.
That's why. Okay.
I don't like it.
I almost feel like some sort of, okay. Understood. Your children moving, ain't they?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
because I'm getting the word move and I'm getting changed. Well, that makes sense. I'm like, are you moving? Something's moving. Something's changing. Okay. Your children are moving.
They're supposed to be moving. Yes.
Okay. How you feel about that? Are you ready to party?
I have mixed emotions because I want them to go out and be young adults, but at the same time, they have my grandbaby, and I want my grandbaby to stay with me.
No, your grandbaby will be fine.
They have to go away, because I'm going to say this. After they move, things are going to start to change in your life as well, in connection to the relationship that you're in. It's going to expand and broaden in ways that I don't think that you recognize.
I feel, that's funny because I feel that, because it's so funny to say it, but they weren't here all weekend, and just the connection that we had with the children, it was it was something to look forward to.
So you need to book a vacation then, don't y'all? Y'all need to go out of town.
Yes, honey.
I will also say, keep looking at that finger, that one finger. Something's going to be there soon.
Wow. I'm excited.
Oh,
really
shoot.
Excited.
See, I didn't pick up on that one. Oh, shoot. Well, pre-congratulations.
Well, thank you.
The only other thing I would say is please make sure you're getting some rest because I keep getting dizzy, and I don't know why I'm getting dizzy or who I'm picking up on, but I keep getting dizzy as we sitting here talking.
I've been having that the last, I'm going to say, 2 weeks or so, and I was thinking about going to get checked for diabetes.
How's your heart health? How's your heart?
As far as I know, great.
Okay.
It's not her.
She mentioned
dizziness.
That's who?
That's her fiance.
He's the one with the heart trouble? Okay. He has flutters? Does he have AFib?
I've been having some flutters off and on, kind of spaced out.
Okay. Are you having the flutters when you're having a dizziness?
No.
Okay.
Different times.
Okay. Yeah, go get checked. Make sure he's staying on top of his stuff, too.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, Queen.
All right.
Well,
thank you very much. I appreciate you. Happy New Year to everyone.
Happy New Year to you. We love you.
Love you also. Blessings.
Peace.
Ladies, be safe. I appreciate you sticking with me.
All right. We'll talk to you in a little bit.
All right.
Okay, Jazz, we got 2 minutes left in the show. I thank you so much. I told the people again to make sure they're reaching out to you for any personal sessions at jazzthemedium.com. Real quick, because we do got 2 minutes left. Jazz, you pick up on anything for me?
What opportunities you got coming up? You got something coming up, don't you?
I was just told that last night by someone else who read me, and she said I had an opportunity coming up.
You got a big opportunity coming up, okay, and it may even put some money in your pocket. So, most definitely, Queen, you got some good things coming up. I see this being a great year for you, okay?
Okay.
So, that's what's sticking out to me the most, and popping in your love life.
I wish something was popping before this thing goes dry.
Well, honey, I made you something, and I'm putting it in the mail tomorrow or Tuesday. I made everything tonight while waiting on the call, so I made you an oil for that.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Yes, I definitely need it. Jazz, it's such a pleasure to have you on, man. I enjoy you every time you come on. And, again, I hope you come back next month for us and do something for me again. You know, the people love to have
anytime,
you on. It's the most honor I've had since I've started on the Walk with the Ancestors radio, period, with the 13 callers you had tonight. It stayed steady at 13, between 12 and 13, and that's the most calls I've had since I started the show on my own broadcasting system. So I just want to say thank you again, Queen, okay?
Thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yeah, y'all check her out at jazzthemedium.com.
Yes, thank you.
All right, Queen. I love you very much. Have a good night.
I love you too. Peace.
Peace. All right, y'all. This has been Soul Sessions Live. Make sure you check us out each and every Wednesday and Sunday night, 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I'll be here Wednesday. We'll be live streaming from Instagram. And also Sunday, we'll have my Shira Taylor on. Make sure you're checking us out also on Fridays for A Walk with Crime. This has been Soul Sessions Live. We're out.
To schedule your individual session, group, or party with me, Quatita Dean, the Ancestral Interpreter, call 513-328-0061 and get connected today. Remember, heaven is only a call away.
When it comes to safety, nothing is more important than your vehicle's brakes. If it's hard to stop or you hear squealing or grinding noises during braking, stop by O'Reilly Auto Parts. You'll find the brake parts you need from trusted brands like BrakeBest and BrakeBest Select at everyday low prices. Play it safe with brakes from O'Reilly Auto Parts. Better parts, better prices, every day.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.